Hey there! So you've heard about Substance Design and New Path and Spline nodes, and you want to have a go at it with a simple exercise. This video is for you. I'm going to show how you can use some of these new nodes to scatter elements along complex shapes, which is something that wasn't really possible before in Designer. So I have this quilted leather, and I wish to place stitches around each bump, and I also wish that they automatically update if I change the pattern here. Now, the graph is pretty simple. I start with a leather base that I actually didn't create from scratch. As you can see, I'm using an existing leather from the Substance 3D Assets library. And basically, I then emboss it with these patterns that I have right here, and that I can swap with that multi-switch node. All that is missing is the stitching. I already prepared my thread here. And now we need to find a way to scatter these stitches along those shapes. How can we do that? Now, your first impulse might be to type scatter in your search bar and bring the scatter on spline in your graph. But the problem is that you don't have any spline yet, so you need to somehow create them based on that grayscale mask that drives the emboss. To do so, you first need to generate path from your mask. Just type in mask and click on mask to path. Then connect your mask to it. It will display a default preview that can be hard to read, so usually when I work with complex masks, I like to use the preview path node and increase the thickness to see better what's going on. I also like to add my mask in the background to have a point of reference. Now let's make a few adjustments to our path. We don't really need to play with the smoothness slider as our mask is already blurred, but the threshold slider is key here. It will offset the path based on the grayscale range, so I'm just going to push it until the path falls roughly where the stitches should be. When I'm happy with it, I can get rid of the preview node, I don't need it anymore, and I can convert my path to splines using the Path to Spline node. Now, you can't really see the splines right now, but it's okay, they will mostly look like the path we just built. Alright, now that we have splines, we can finally use the scatter node. I'm going to use the scatter on spline color for this example because, as you can see, I use the RGBA merge node to assign separate elements to separate channels. It's a neat trick that will let me scatter different patterns using only one single scatter node, and then extract them afterwards with an RGBA split. You will see in a moment what I'm talking about. So let's just hook our splines to the scatter. And if the connections don't come together, just enable Material Mode here in your toolbar. And you already start to see the default scatter, neatly following our mask. Perfect. Let's now bring our thread in and plug it into the pattern input. And enable Custom Pattern. All right. Right off the bat, it looks pretty good. We have our thread in red and the little holes in green. We can retrieve them after the scatter by splitting the color channels using an RGBA split, like so. Now, if we go back to the scatter itself, as you can see, we have a lot of parameters to play with. I'm going to leave most of them untouched as the default look works fine for me. The main parameter you may want to adjust is the shape spacing. You can increase it if you want something less dense, but let's just keep a pretty low value like 0.11. Another interesting option when it comes to stitches is the Duplicate tab. You can repeat your scatter several times and control the offset, and make some kind of double top stitch like that. There's also a circular mode that lets you achieve very precise effects. The rest of the parameters should feel familiar. We have size, rotation, color, and all of these can be, of course, randomized as you would expect. Now let's just take our scattered threads and add them to our main stream. I'm going to take the puncture first and subtract them from the leather. All right. Then take the stitches and add them on top. Perfect. We're almost done here, but there's one last detail I'd like to add to make the stitches come to life, so to say. You can see on my final render that there is some puckering occurring along these lines. Now, to create this effect, let's just add another scatter on spline. We will take the same splines, but do a different scatter. This time I'm going to take a bell shape because it has that nice soft look. And I will elongate it using the size parameters, pushing the Y to something like 3. Under the position tab, I'm going to offset the line along the normals because I don't want the puckering to be in the exact same spot as the stitches. So minus 0.1 should do. And now we can add a bit of chaos to it by randomizing things like the scale, the luminance. I'm also going to increase the shape spacing slightly because I think the scatter might be too dense right now. All right. Let's now blend this with our main height and see how it looks. Not bad. As you can see, I added a mask in the opacity slot to soften a little the effect in the middle of the interstices. I think it really helps making the puckering more subtle and realistic. And that's it. You can now change your pattern and have your stitches automatically follow the new shapes. So you now know how to use the Path and Spline toolset to do advanced mask-driven scattering. Remember, just go mask to path, path to spline, and then scatter on spline. I hope you now feel more confident using these tools and that you will have fun experimenting with them.